Hello dear friends, welcome to my channel Keratoconus Herb TV. Now I will tell you very important things that every keratoconus sufferer should know who is going for corneal collagen crosslinking. Here I will discuss two popular techniques of performing CXL, known as CXL with Epithelium-On and CXL with Epithelium-Off. In short, they are also called as Epi-On and Epi-Off. You will also get the idea about the pros and cons of both of these techniques, which one is better and why. So let's compare cross-linking with Epi-On and Off. There are two popular techniques for the CXL, Epithelium-On and Off. Epithelium-On, that is not removing the epithelium, and Epithelium-Off, which means removing the epithelium. Epithelium is the membrane of tissues which covers the internal body organs. Here in this case, it means corneal membrane. These are also popular by the short names as Epi-On and Epi-Off. In Epithelium-On, the corneal membrane, that is the epithelium, is not removed for the cross-linking surgical procedure, while in case of Epithelium-Off, it is removed before applying riboflavin, that is the vitamin B2. Which technique is better has been a controversial topic, as there are some advantages and disadvantages associated with each of them. So let's here discuss the comparison between these two popular techniques. Keeping the epithelium makes the Epithelium-On less painful as compared to Epithelium-Off technique. Since epithelium is not removed in Epi-On, so it leads to faster healing and also reduces the chances of infection. Although the Epi-On may seem more attractive to many because of the above mentioned reasons, but it has been found that Epi-On is less effective in comparison to Epi-Off. Epi-Off technique came into practice before the Epi-On. So Epi-Off has longer history and larger number of case studies as compared to Epi-On. Epi-On is recommended in cases when thickness of the cornea is not enough to perform a standard Epi-Off procedure. But nowadays, Epi-On is gaining popularity because of its many advantages, like less painful, lower risks of infections, fast recovery, etc. As the number of patients treated with Epi-On is increasing with time, more case studies are available for research and to compare the outcomes and efficacy of these two procedures. If you want more information about keratoconus, you are welcome on my blog www.keratoconusherb.com. I have committed to add more videos regularly to keep you updated with latest advancements in keratoconus. To get the notifications of my new videos, don't forget to subscribe my channel, Keratoconus Herb TV. Thank you for watching.